Welcome back to my channel. First, I will explain about what is the purpose of arc contact, arc runner, then arc shoot, and later I will explain about testing of each trips. Circuit breaker operation. Whenever opening or closing of circuit breaker, arc is produced due to jumping of electron between this contact, not only in circuit breaker but also in contactor, relay, and even when the switch is on while connecting a charger to the socket, you might have seen this arc. If you see the diagram in right hand side, fixed contact is live, moving contact which is come closer to the fixed contact at the point of contact, arc is produced. It may damage the contact. So in order to protect the main contact, we are using a arc contact. During closing operation of breaker, arc contact closes first and then after main contact closes. During opening operation of breaker, main contact separate first and after arc contact it separated. And the circuit breaker not only designed for make or break the contact, but also it is designed to extinguish and cool the temperature at arc terminal. In high voltage, temperature at arc terminal is more than 35,000 degree Fahrenheit, which is nearly 4 times the temperature of sun surface. So the arc which is traveled through the arc runner and extinguished in arc splitter. For better understanding, you will see this video, you will know how it is extinguished, and in real time it take less than 3 milliseconds for short circuit and make or break operation. This is the circuit diagram for an air circuit breaker. If you look at this diagram, transformer 440 volt is converted into 110 volt and then using rectifier AC to DC. Here everything is DC. I had seen my last ship, under voltage coil was 220 volt AC. So ship to ship it can vary. For testing, we have to apply rated voltage or current for the safety devices. Testing of trips. Under voltage trip, or another name is no volt coil, set at 50 to 70% of rated voltage. When voltage drops below the set value of UVT setting, then UVT coil trip the breaker, and it also prevent the circuit breaker from being closed when generator producing a low voltage or zero voltage. This trip can be tested by voltage injection method. Overcurrent trip. It is due to the overload of generator, so it can be tested by current injection method. The time delay in overcurrent trip, it depends on the percentage of full load current. Both overcurrent trip and under voltage trip tests are done by shore technician. Reverse power trip. We will do the testing of reverse power trip when two generators are running in parallel. Put the control of testing generator in manual and also governor in manual mode. Adjust the governor in anti-clockwise direction, that is, we are lowering the load and shifting the load to the another generator. At the set value of reverse power trip setting, it will open the breaker. During this testing, running generator should not be overloaded, so make sure that load is minimum while doing this test. Preferential trip can be tested either by primary current injection method or secondary current injection method. This trip arrangement for an overload of generator, so we are applying a current injection method for testing this preferential trip. If you want to test the whole system, we would use primary current injection method, or if you want to test the timing relay, we would use secondary current injection method. This test should be done by technician from shore, and they have a separate kit or device for testing this preferential trip. Thank you for watching this video.